tries to join the horde of voices saying no to this bill. Mr. Speaker, it doesn't need too much saying, the fact that civil society organizations, particularly those ones in the Southwest, fought and led to what we have today that we call Democracy Nigeria. Organizations that I belong to, including the National Association of Nigerian Students, fought across the country against military rule for us to attain the democracy that we enjoy today. If by any means, Mr. Speaker, we agree that they should be regulated by governments that sometimes in Nigeria leave a lot to be desired, many of those donors who bring money for these organizations to run so that people can have a say in what happens in their country, even when they have no say in their own governance, those agencies will run away. And only God can imagine what will befall us as a nation if we cannot even say no, or have people who can say no when things begin to go terribly wrong in this country. Mr. Speaker, there have been various people over time who had wanted a situation where the donors and their funds are regulated by a commission. I'm sure this bill at some point will also want to know how much comes from where and how, and then determine how it is even spent, so that they can impute some level of corruption in it, so that they can begin to corrupt the process. Any attempt, Mr. Speaker, for us as a House to allow this bill to even pass the second reading, we'll be sending very negative messages to whoever is watching us outside this country. It will say that we are not serious about transparency, because the only people who shine light at our electoral process, at our judicial process, and at our governance system are those civil society groups who independently go without need for support from our government, without need for approval from me or from you, to look at what we are doing and make reports that show that we are either transparent or not, which reports encourage us to get better. If we begin to attempt to stifle them in the guise of regulating them, and then begin to say at some point that you cannot operate in Nigeria, we will arrest you because you're not registered with the commission, then we are on the way to a draconian state that none of us here wants to have happen in this country. So on the basis of that, Mr. Speaker, without belaboring the issue, I want to lean also very heavily on the position of the Professor Inhomberi in saying that this bill should not be withdrawn, Mr. Speaker. It shouldn't be withdrawn, because withdrawing it will mean that it can be reintroduced. We should kill it right here so that it will not come back again. Thank you, Mr. Speaker. So submit.